opportunity to come and to gather and to bless your holy name. And Lord God, as we worship you and as we praise you tonight, Lord, I ask you, Lord, that the power of the Holy Ghost would fill this house once again. Lord God, I pray that we would not leave the same way that we came, Lord, but that we would leave strengthened, edified, and encouraged tonight. Lord, touch your body, for we are the body of Christ tonight, Lord. And God, I ask you that you would touch this body in Jesus' name. And the church said, amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Standing on the promises of God. Amen. Anybody in here ever received a promise before from the Lord? Amen. Got to stand on it, don't you? Amen. Don't forget it. Amen. Claim it. Stand on it. Amen. Hallelujah. We're standing on the promises of Christ.
Thank you.
bustling pastor. He had gotten away into a life of filth and immorality, so far away from God. But the Holy Ghost was dealing with his heart. Amen. Aren't you thankful that God doesn't give up on that backslider? Oh my goodness. He began to cry out unto the Lord, "Lord, I'm sorry for the mess that I've made. I repent. I turn away from this wicked life that I've had. Lord, I'm running back to you." And he began to write the words of this song. Only believe. Amen. Hallelujah. He knew that if God's going to change my life, all I've got to do is believe. Amen. All things are possible. Amen. Let's lift our hands and sing it by faith tonight.
All things are possible.
presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. I want to say we are so happy to have everybody here in service with us tonight. Amen. I've been feasting, well, just all week off of the message from Sunday night. Amen. Just wonderful services that we had. Amen. I'll tell you, God has been good to us, hasn't he? Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Sister Mary, testify.
I just love the Lord, and you know, the last time I testified, I said, you know, train up a child in the way they should go, and when they're old, they won't depart from it. I'm glad Seth's not here. I wanted to share this. There was an incident at school today, and it involved Seth, and Seth has been going to the same school since kindergarten. He's never had any fights, or everybody just loves him. They just love him, but today they were playing tag, and you know, their kids are playing, and this one kid tossed the football to try to distract. Seth was it. They were playing tag. Seth was it. He was just about ready to tag another kid, and so another kid tossed the football. A teacher was watching, tossed the football, and when he tossed it, it caught Seth in the face. He tossed it pretty hard. Caught Seth in the face, and Seth didn't know who had tossed the football or what happened, because he was concentrating on tagging that kid. Well, this other kid happened to run up at the same time, and Seth thought that that kid hit him, and Seth just reacted and pushed that kid. And the rules are at the school, you don't put your hands on any other kid like that. And right away, his teacher that was describing what happened to him, right away, she said Seth just began to weep because he knew that what he had done was wrong. And he didn't want to get disciplined for it because our write-up at school, he wouldn't have been able to participate in any of the field trip tomorrow or the reward that's on Friday or anything else that was happening. And he was so upset, and he told his teacher, goes, I cannot believe that I reacted that way. What is wrong with me? He was just beating himself up because he reacted that way. And she told him, Seth, you're human. You're going to react in different ways. But what you have to learn is how to control yourself. It's called self-control. And she said, and we all have to learn it. She said, even as adults, we have to learn it. And she said, Mary, she said, Seth was so convicted over that. And the other kid that threw the football put his arm around Seth and said, I'm so sorry. It's my fault that you acted that way. I'm so sorry. And then the kid that he pushed, they made him walk away because he was kind of upset with Seth. And they're like, really good friends. And Seth said, I can't. He didn't tell me about it. And I thought, okay, he thinks that I don't know about this. And so I asked him, I said, how was school today? Oh, it was great. Mom, it was great. And I said, okay, so how was your finals? Oh, good. And I said, did anything happen? No. And I said, well, I know something happened. And then he just lost it. And he said, Mom, I'm so sorry. I would never do that. And he said, I would never do that. And I said, well, did you apologize? He goes, yes, I apologize. He goes, but I don't understand why I reacted that way. You know, we're humans. Right. And I told him, I said, Seth, it's just like Miss Monica said, we're humans. And we're going to have different reactions. I said, but when you put the word of God in you, and you get that deep in you, I said, you're going to react the way Jesus would react. Yes. I said, so you need to desire more of God's word in your life and hunger for it. And he said, Mom, he said, I don't ever, ever want to do that again to anybody. He said, pray with me. And so we just prayed. And you know what? Our kids watch us.
Yes.
And you know, he said, Mom, he said, I know that whenever you're got a problem or you're not feeling, I know that you pray. He says, so pray with me, pray for me, pray that I never act like that again. I don't want to be that kind of person. But what he didn't know is that on the other end, the teacher said, Mary, she said, everybody loves Seth. He is just the example of what every parent wants their child to be. She said, whatever you and Randy are doing, she goes, keep doing it. She said, because everybody loves him. She said, even the boy that he pushed, he's known to just come right back at you and punch you and push you. But he knew that Seth, that was not Seth, that wasn't like Seth. He said it, and she said the other little boy told her, she said, I don't know what was wrong with Seth. He goes, maybe he's having a bad day, but he'll never do something like that. So you know what? Our children watch us.
Yes.
And I thank God that Seth learned from this, and that he learned that he can go to God and
yes.
trust in God, that he can stand on God's promises and know that when he's got a difficult situation at school or at home or whatever, that he can rely on God. And you know, our children watch us, and we set that yes. example before us. And I just thank God because he didn't react and just, you know, go all out. He shoved him, and then he went like that because he caught himself.
Amen.
And you know what? Isn't that just like the Holy Spirit? When
yes,
we are doing something
yes.
that is not pleasing to God, the Holy Spirit will convict us.
Right.
But what will
right.
we do?
Yes,
will we keep
yes.
on, or are we going to say, wait?
Amen.
Okay, God, I know
Amen.
This is not right. And you know, I thank God that we are being that example before Seth. And I do have a prayer request along that. We have a decision that we need to make concerning Seth. So, I don't really know much. But we need guidance.
Yes. Amen. Amen. We'll remember.
And I love the Lord.
Yeah. You kind of scared me.
Sorry.
Hey, easy, sis. I know it's a spirit-filled church, but easy. You scared me with all that emotion. Brother Steve.
I've been at work since 7 this morning. Carried a heavy breather, blowing some arms, just so tired.
Yeah.
I just got home. I was going to take a shower, but I just came. And I was worshiping, and I got into the spirit, so I just got really wasn't here. My arms were so tired, they were hurting. And I felt the Lord, I felt God just kind of, he just got real light, and he just kind of pulled him up higher.
Amen.
And it looked so light, you know. And then when we said to be seated, I didn't hear it right away for a few seconds later, because I wasn't ready to sit down yet. And I kind of came to you, and I go, okay, I'm ready to sit down. So like, you may be seated if you can.
Yeah,
you can. But I was just working so hard, you know, from my heart. And
Amen.
My arms were so tired, I just wanted to put them down. And I just felt they got so light. I just felt them just pull them up. They were like feathers, you know?
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know what Sister Mary was saying? I think about that a lot, Sister Mary. You know, a lot of times the enemy, he'll come at you and he'll say, you know, how could you have done this? Or what were you thinking? We all, Pastor William faces that. But I'll tell you, a lot of times I'll think, you know, God may deal with me in one thing. He didn't deal with me in that particular area years ago. But now, God is dealing with it and he decides to take it out. What does that mean? That means you're growing.
Amen.
Amen. You know, if you look at a plant outside, you can stare at it all day long and you're going to say, there ain't nothing happening. Amen. But you go a couple weeks without looking at that thing, that plant, and you'll come back and say, wow, it looks totally different. Amen. Amen. So get our eyes off ourselves.
Yeah.
Just keep focusing on God. Amen. And we'll grow. Amen. That's a good testimony, Sister Mary. Really is. Amen. Amen. I could preach on that. I really could. Amen. Amen. But we do want to go to the Lord. And did you say something, Brother Steve?
Yeah. I was talking to my cousin Michael, Lane's brother. He said, Stevie said, I go, we just want to be family. He said, we love you, Michael. He said, well, why don't we try the family thing? So after a while, and then he said, I go, Jesus still loves you, Michael. He turned and said, you know, Steve, I was in church for 25 years. I prayed. I've done things in church. I was faithful and everything. He said, I prayed all that time. I never heard God's voice. He never answered none of my prayers. He said, but I'm going through something right now, but maybe later. And I thought, God, a lot of people are that way today. They're in church, they're faithful, they do things in church, they do a lot of things for God, but he didn't know God.
Right.
You know, he never heard his voice in his heart. He'd done a lot of things, but he was so faithful for 25 years, so he just left. You know what I mean? I mean, he said God would be prayed every day. He was like in a religious order. He'd pray to God all the time, and he'd done all these things, you know, and Bible studies and everything, and read his word. And people say, well, that man's saved, but he didn't know God. So finally, he just gave up and left. That's what he told me. And I'm like, oh, Jesus still loves you, Michael.
Amen.
And I got a guy I deal with every Sunday. Remember he helped me kick that ivy off the wall? He called me and said he had a stroke, and his arm was kind of, it didn't look so bad. I went over there the other day to do his yard, and he came out of his hammock when he was on the cane. He was so weak, and I felt his hurt, you know. I just wanted to pray with him, you know, lay hands on him, but he just wanted me to pray for him. He didn't want me to pray with him. I felt so badly. I mean, I felt him, you know, I mean, I felt the pain.
Amen.
And, you know, that it was going, but, you know, I had to say, God.
Yes.
I just keep praying. Because I think about his name was Sundance.
Sundance.
He don't know God.
All right.
He's got a family. I never see his wife. I think she's dying. Well,
let's lift him up in prayer.
Yeah, I felt that. I was so weak, you know,
yes.
Coming down the steps. And I told him, you know, I just do this prayer. I'm going to come down 3 times a week. I'm going to help him more with the yard because of his condition. I just wanted to lay hands on him and pray, but he don't want it, you know. Yeah, I felt so bad. You know?
Amen. Let's remember that name. Let's remember Sister Lorraine. Let's also remember Sister Mary and Brother Randy's unspoken request. Amen. Let's remember those tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, we just love you and we thank you. You are a prayer answering God, Lord. Your ear is there, Lord, for the righteous. Lord, it's open to the righteous, Lord. Your ear is open to their cry. Father, I ask you tonight, Lord, that you would just meet and answer every request that's been brought before you tonight. I pray for Sundance right now, Lord, that you would just touch that physical body. Lord God, restore that which this stroke, Lord, has just really messed up, God. Lord, restore that body. Lord, most of all, speak to his heart, Lord. In the name of Jesus, and I pray that you would give Brother Steve wisdom, give him understanding, Lord. God, give them the words to say, Lord, to reach this person for you in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for Sister Mary and Brother Randy's request. Lord God, you know all about it. You know how important this decision is, Father, in Jesus' name. Lord God, I ask you, Lord, that you would lead and guide, Lord, in Jesus' name. And Lord, we pray for Sister Lorraine tonight. We pray, God, that you would just touch her, strengthen her, encourage her tonight in Jesus' name. And Lord, we continue to pray for the lost. We continue to pray for the broken, the hurting, Lord, the outcast. Lord God, I ask you that you would save them. Lord God, I pray, Lord, for Angel. I pray for his girlfriend. I pray, Lord, for Elston. I pray for Melina. Lord God, touch this community. In Jesus' name, Lord, I ask you, Lord, that you would continue to move in a mighty way. Lord, we just give you all the praise, all the glory. In Jesus' name, and New Hope Church said, amen and amen. Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise tonight. And Nathan, won't you come and take up the offering tonight? And while Nathan is coming and taking up the offering, I'm going to go ahead and make a couple of announcements real quickly. Remember, tomorrow night, we're going to be taking the widows and the single senior women out to Golden Corral. All right. So it'll be the widows and the single senior women. Say that 3 times. Amen. But we just want to do that just because we want to care for those that don't have a companion. Amen. We want to just love on them and just fellowship with them, amen, and just take care of them, amen. So do remember that tomorrow night. We'll probably start picking people up about 5 o'clock. So Sister Jessie will probably be over your house about 5, and then we'll move towards the east. All right, so amen. But we'll pick you up and take care of Golden Corral. Amen. You like Golden Corral?
Yeah.
All right, amen, amen. If you don't, there's a variety, just come and fellowship. Amen. So do remember that. And also, remember this Sunday morning. I have never done this. I don't usually like doing this. But there's a brother that called me. And he's an older gentleman. He's in his mid-80s. He's an old general. And he called me on... He called me just Monday afternoon, and he asked, he said, Brother William, I don't know if you remember me, he said, but I preached for your father years ago, and he said, I'm going to be in the area. I'll only be there for that Sunday morning because I'm preaching somewhere else Sunday night. And he asked if he would come, and at first I thought to myself, this is Sunday morning.